Hey guys, welcome to this brand new series of videos entitled From Screen to Stage. Here, we're going to take a look at various movie-based musicals in an attempt to find out if these musicals are better or worse than their movie counterparts. So, for this first episode, let's talk about Shrek. Shrek, originally a story by author William Stave, was made famous by the DreamWorks 2001 film of the same name, starring Mike Myers as Shrek, Cameron Diaz as the lovely Princess Fiona, John Lithgow as the evil Lord Farquaad, and Eddie Murphy as the lovable jackass, Donkey. The movie made roughly $485 million worldwide, spawned three sequels, a theme park attraction in Universal Studios, two holiday specials, and yes, the subject of today's episode, a Broadway musical. Now, the musical version premiered on Great White Way in 2008, starring Brian D'Arcy James as Shrek, Sutton Foster as Fiona, Christopher Seaver as Lord Farquaad, and Daniel Breaker as Donkey. Now, since this was a musical, it obviously needed original songs, and Shrek got them, courtesy of the team-up of Janine Tesori and David Lindsay-Abaire. The musical ran from November 8th of 2008 through to January 3rd of 2010, with a total of 441 performances. At the time, it was one of the most expensive musicals to open on Broadway, at an estimated $25 million, and despite generally good reviews, it failed to recoup its initial investment. So, with all that out of the way, let's start the comparison. The characters. Now this category is rather simple, as the musical version doesn't really add much to the characters from the film. Shrek still acts like Shrek, Donkey still acts like Donkey, etc. Sure, there are characters that are given different personalities and characteristics from the film, like Pinocchio and Gingy, who have a bit more of a dark side in the musical. But perhaps the biggest downgrade between film and stage is the portrayal of Lord Farquaad. In Shrek the Musical, Farquaad's more of a man-child, bound for revenge on his father. This slightly brings down how seriously you can take Lord Farquaad as a villain, especially when compared to John Lithgow's menacing voiceover version from the film. I don't blame Shrek the Musical, as trying to recreate characters like Shrek and Donkey, who at this stage were already cultural icons with identifiable characteristics, is a very daunting task. One that, I truly believe, would have backfired in the long run. And it honestly wasn't what they set out initially to do. So, while none of these changes from the movie take away from the overall enjoyment of the musical, in the end, the original film just does them better. The visual look. This is probably the hardest category to judge, as both are very visually impressive in their respective mediums. Shrek, the movie, was visually impressive, with worlds rich in different landscapes. Each place the characters went to had its own look and color palette that felt unique to that area. The Dragon's Keep felt ominous and foreboding, rich in reds and golds, while Duloc felt pristine and well-ordered, full of green grass and blue skies. So, does Shrek the Musical surpass these visuals while still making them their own? Yes. Shrek the Musical managed to recreate so many things from the film that many probably thought were impossible. I can speak from experience, as when I first heard about it, I thought DreamWorks were crazy. How can we possibly transform an actor into Shrek? How can we possibly pull off a fire-breathing dragon? But DreamWorks theatricals not only managed to meet my expectations, they surpassed them via the use of impressive makeup and puppetry that still blows me away to this day. The costumes for every character has its own unique look and are very appealing to look at. But perhaps the most impressive aspect of Shrek the Musical is the transformation of lead actor Brian D'Arcy James to the green ogre we all know and love. When in full costume, you truly believe he is Shrek, which is an impressive feat. And to see a real actor in Shrek makeup go through the emotional twists and turns of this story is something, in my opinion, that this story deserved. The amount of things Shrek the Musical had to be able to pull off, night after night, to a live audience, to bring this story to life, is something that I think is more deserving of a point for the overall better visual look. The story. So, story-wise, both movie and musical tell the story the same way, but the musical has a major advantage over the film that, in my opinion, makes it better. The musical numbers. These songs help show us how a character is feeling during a particular scene. But perhaps more importantly, the musical numbers also tell us why the characters are doing what they're doing, in a way that the movie just couldn't accomplish. Two significant examples of this are the scenes When Will It Fail and Gonna Build a Wall. Originally taking place in scenes that were so cliché in the movie, the songs here make the scenes more heartbreaking than they ever were in the film. In addition, adding music also gave the creative team the opportunity to give us more lore and history to the Shrek universe, answering some questions like, how did Shrek arrive on his swamp? Or, why does Farquaad hate fairy tale creatures? These answers, which may seem inconsequential to some, make the world more rich and thriving, which in turn adds to the story, making it more real to the audience. Finally, the musical also has a fairy tale creature subplot. Basically, the subplot deals with the fairy tale creatures, mainly Pinocchio, mirroring Shrek and Fiona's journey, learning that our differences are things to be celebrated, not discouraged. While some may argue that it's redundant, I disagree. In the film, we don't really know how the fairy tale creatures feel about being outcasts. They act as if nothing's really happened. To me, having the fairy tale creatures feel bad about themselves, like Shrek and Fiona do, makes them more believable characters, as that's how real people would act. So overall, it's for these reasons that I feel the musical tells the better story. So, in the end, Shrek the Musical reigns supreme. This is not an insult to the original movie, as without it, I doubt the musical version would even exist, at least in its current form. Shrek is still a delightful movie that I urge anyone who hasn't yet seen it to go search it out, and I doubt they'll be disappointed. But, when looking at it analytically, with an overall better visual look and storytelling, the musical version just comes out on top. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I sure enjoyed making it. On the screen right now, you will be seeing two links to our videos on this channel. On the left is a link to the first episode of the show called Pilot Obscurities, in which I took a look at the adventures of Jimmy Neutron Boy Genius's pilot, Runaway Rocket Boy. And on the right is a link to the first episode of Every Disney Animated Movie Reviewed, in which I took a look at Walt Disney's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Again, guys, don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, do all that stuff, because it really does help me out a lot. And until next time, guys, I'll be seeing you. Bye.